Hello everyone, welcome to the IchimokuCharts.com daily analysis for the Aussie dollar, US dollar, FX futures for Monday, July the 18th, 2011. Well, a continuation of the trend to the downside today, and the candle that we're analysing is the second last candle appearing on the chart. The last candle is the market currently trading in the current 24-hour period, which is unfinished, so we need to disregard that at the moment. But the second last candle here, we had the market make a lower high and a lower low, continuing the trend to the downside. We've had a breakout down below the cloud, the Ichimoku cloud, and that's a bearish signal with Ichimoku charts. Having said that, however, it wasn't a terribly bearish breakout. Even though we did have a red-bodied candle, which denotes the sellers making net bearish progress on the day between the open and the close, we had a large shadow on the bottom of the candle denoting a loss of commitment from the sellers as they were trading down at lower levels. And that loss of commitment coincided with some strong areas of support down around 105, which is a very big number for this market, and certainly trading to the Kijun Sen, which is trading at 104.90, and down into this large zone that we've highlighted in yellow, which is a very strong area of previous support at various levels extending down to 102.81. So we've seen the upside price rejection on this candle as evidenced by the shadow here. Now, having said that, with the market being bearish in the big picture terms, the market is still bullish in the medium-term time frame by trading up above the Kijun Sen, which is the pink line here, but only just. But the market is retracing back towards the Kijun Sen, which is what happens when the Kijun Sen turns flat. There's a very high probability of that happening, and the market has found support at around those levels. The market is, however, trading down below the Tenkan-sen. We can just see the green line here that the market has traded through in today's trading, and that denotes the market being bearish in the fast-term time frame. Now, if this market is going to rally, and there's no suggestion that it will, even though the sellers have lost commitment and they haven't really got control of this market, we don't have the buyers attempting to take control yet. But if we do see the buyers take control, we do have solid resistance at 105.69, and the resistance extends all the way up through the cloud here. That extends up to 106.08, roughly, or 106, actually. So if we do see the market test up to those levels, we need to watch that area at the top of 106.4, a bullish breakout. If we do have a bullish breakout to the upside, then there is a good likelihood that the market will test up to around 107, but there should be very, very strong resistance up at that level. And we can see the region near 107 was tested on quite a few occasions, and the market sold off. The buyers lost commitment around that level. To the downside, as we've seen, we have very strong support down below at certain levels all the way through this highlighted yellow area, and that's the main areas are these swing lows at 104.35, 103.55 and 102.81. So very, very strong support down below. So for the next day's trading, we do need to watch the low of the current candle for a potential test down to 104.35, because the trend is down. We don't have any evidence yet that the trend is going to change. But certainly watch up around the 105.69 area for a test to within the cloud, and a potential test to the top of the cloud at around 106.